is a particle. Particle is the smallest division of a body. Like, atom is for an element, the compound is for a molecule. In the same manner, the particle is for a body. And it is moving at a constant velocity from a particular point. The value of this velocity is 1.2 meters per second. 2 seconds are over for this motion. After that 2 seconds, another particle starts from the same point and in the same direction like the first. But for this second body or the second point, whatever the case may be, the velocity is 1.5 meters per second, and that is the velocity at the start. Besides, this second particle is moving with an acceleration also, the value for which is 0.9 meters per second. When the two particles meet, that is the question. Well, after 2 seconds of motion is over, the second particle will start. But still, the second particle is having a higher velocity and also acceleration, so velocity will further increase. So that is why what happens is that for 2 seconds only the first body is moving, and then afterwards second particle will move faster even though it starts late, and therefore they will meet at one point because the increasing speed of the second. Where is that meeting point is the question. So then, we have got a particle moving with a constant velocity. So we will say u1 is equal to constant, and that is equal to 1.2 meters per second. There is no acceleration here. So a1 is equal to 0. And let us take at the meeting point the time. T1 is equal to T. What more can you say for this motion? Anybody? Come on, man. At least one question you should give an answer. Is it not? Every time I ask a question, I myself give the answer. Not fair, isn't it? Okay, try that. So now we're coming to the point. You see, what is common between the two motions is that they start from the same point, both of them. And they also meet, means they are both finally at the same point. Then only they can meet. So starting point is same and the final point is also same, means both are going to cover the same displacement, same distance. Because it is a straight line, you can give any meaning. So if S1 is equal to S, then S2 is also equal to S. Okay. So now, for another particle, I will call it as a C. 2 seconds are over, then the second particle will start. But now it is given that the velocity at the start for the second particle is 1.5 meters per second. Keeps moving. And it is meeting with the first particle at point D. So B and D are the same points. A and D are also the same points. Okay. So now, for the second particle, the relevant information is that there is an acceleration A2 which is not zero and is given to be equal to 0.9 meters per second square. What about the time? It starts 2 seconds late, but the starting point is the same. If the first body is in motion for 2 seconds, then the second body is moving. It starts 2 seconds late, so it is going to take less time. A good example for that is, you start at 5 o'clock from your house to reach the bus stop and you take 5 minutes. Another person meets you at the bus stop but he starts 2 minutes later. You have taken 5 minutes, he will start 2 minutes afterwards. So when he starts 2 minutes afterwards and meets you at the bus stop means he is taking less time. 2 minutes afterwards he will start, but he is meeting you. So he is taking less time, naturally. 2 minutes less time. All that minute is in seconds for this question. So it is going to be 2 seconds less. So for this, the time T2 is equal to t minus 2, so 2 seconds less. And besides that, the distance covered by this body will be the same as the first, because they are meeting and both are starting from the same point. Okay. So for all this information, we will have to find out where are they meeting. So this one, how much is it? That is the question. How shall we find it out? For that, see, what is the data given? And accordingly, you will have to select the questions. For the first part, motion A to B. The acceleration is zero, and the distance covered will be equal to S1. So for that, the initial velocity will be U1 into the time T1 plus half into first part A1 into T1 square. A1 is equal to zero because it is moving with constant velocity. So by substituting the proper values, we get S1 is S, which is the same like the second part of the motion. Then U1 is 1.2 and T1 is taken as T plus. Because A1 is 0, the entire term goes. So the first equation that we are getting for the combined motion is S is equal to 1.2T, the equation 1. And then let us take the other motion, which is motion C to D. So here for motion C D is initial velocity is given, the acceleration is also given, and the displacement is the same like the first, and the final time is also given in terms of t. So write the equation and then we will also find out as what to do next. So S2 is equal to U2 into T2 plus half into A2 into T2 square. S2 is the same like the first, so S. Now U2 is equal to 1.5 meters per second. And T2, 2 seconds less than the first. So it will be T minus 2. Plus. Here the acceleration is given and it is 0.9, so A2 put it, and then we have got the time T2, which is equal to T minus 2, the whole square. Okay, so now, coming back, what we now have is, in continuation with the motion CD, we have got S is equal to 1.5T. Open out the bracket in the first term. So it will be 1.5T minus 1.5 into 2 will be equal to 3. And then we have got plus half into 0.9. So that will be equal to 0.45. And then within the brackets, we have got T minus 2 whole square. When you open it out, it will be equal to T square plus 2 square, that is 4. T square, A minus B, the whole square is equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB. So it will be minus 2 into A is equal to T, B is 2. So it will be 2 into 2 into T. Into T. You can simplify this further. So then what you will get is, or S will be equal to 1.5 T minus 3 plus 0.45 T square. Some people express this number as 0.45. That is wrong. Please note. Every number is representing, what is it? 1/10, 1/100, 1/1000, and so on. So when they are representing different scales, how can you count it as one number itself like 0.45? It's wrong, therefore. So to put it correctly, always, whenever you have got a decimal, remember you have to say the numbers there after the decimal separately only, individually. So only saying 0.45 will be correct. Okay. And then we have got 0.45 into 4. So that is equal to, please note there is plus everywhere, so it is going to be plus 1.8. 0.45 into 4. And then 0.45. Here also we have got into 4, this is 2 into 2, remember. So 0.45 into 4, that will be equal to 1.8, but note that there is a minus sign, so minus 1.8. Thereafter, don't forget we have got a T also, so write it. This is also equal to, yes, I will call this as equation 2. Of course, if you want, you can simplify this further. 1.5T minus 1.8T will be equal to minus 0.3t. And then in t square, we have got 0.45. So 0.45t square. And then you can also see that there is a number. Minus 0.3 here, then plus 1.8. So which will be equal to minus 1.2. And that is equal to s. So better call this as equation 2. So now equation 1, equation 2, both are equal to yes. It's not R over here, it is equal to. So putting the equal to sign, then you'll find that in both equation 1 and 2, one side of the equation is equal to S alone. So this is equal to S. So the other sides in both the equations have got to be equal to one another. So what we therefore have is 0.45 t square minus 0.3t minus 1.2 is equal to, on the other side we have got 1.2t. Now, if you bring every term to one side of the equation, you will find that we have got a quadratic equation which goes like this, that 0.45 t square, 1.2 t coming that side becomes minus 1.2 t, another minus 0.3 is there, so both are negative, so you can add it up and put overall minus, which will be now equal to 1.5 t, and then minus 1.2 is also equal, is also there. All this put up together, because everything is brought to one side, so on the other side it will be now equal to 0. So this is a quadratic equation in t, and for that the time t is given by t is equal to, you see, the coefficient of t square is a, the coefficient of t is b, of course because of the minus, so it will be minus b for this equation, and c again because of the minus, c will be equal to minus 1.2. So t will be equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. This is all mere algebra, which you start studying it from the 8th or 9th standard itself. So I don't intend giving the explanation as how we got this equation. Divided by 2 into a. So that will be equal to minus b. B is minus 1.5. So minus b will be plus 1.5. And then you have got plus or minus square root of b square. So b is 1.5. And b square means minus 1.5 or plus 1.5, all has got one of the same meaning when you square it. So 1.5 square will be equal to 2.25 minus 4ac, 4 into a is 0.45. So 4 into 0.45, we know very well it is equal to 1.8. And then c is also there, c is 1.2, minus is also there. So now you can see that 4 into 0.45 is 1.8, and 1.8 multiplied by 1.2. So for an easy simplification of this, 1.8 into 2 is 36. So 0.2 will be 0.36. And 1.8, 1 is still left out, will be equal to, or otherwise, you can take this 2 decimal in the result. So 18 into 1, so that will be equal to 18 only. So this will be equal to 6, 8 plus 3 is 11, then 1 carry over, here 1 plus 1 is 216. Now 2 decimals bring the number to 2 decimals backwards, so the answer will be 2.16. So otherwise, I have already told you 1.8 multiplied by 2, then take 1 decimal, so 1.8 into 2 is 3.6 and 1 decimal before, so 0.36. 1.8 into 1 will be 1.8 only plus 0.36. You will get it equal to 2.16, and that will be very fast. I told you before that I'm going to inform you one day as to how the calculations can be done fast at a later date. So till such time, do these calculations when I am also doing the calculations. Before I start the next step, you are also going to finish the calculation, that is fine. Then you will be also cogent with me. So now, having got the value of 4AC as equal to 2.16 divided by 2 into A. And A, as you can see, is 0.45, so 2 into A will be 0.45 into 2, which is equal to 0.9. And all this time will be in seconds. Now, you cannot take the minus sign here. Sometimes by taking the minus sign also, you will get a positive answer. Then how two positive answers, you have to give an explanation for it. But here, not necessary, because 2.25 minus 2.16 will be equal to, how much? It will be equal to 0.41. So 0.41 is the square root of that. And b square minus 4ac, and there is one more negative in c, so minus 1 to minus becomes plus, so this is plus. Now 2.25 plus 2.16 will be 4.41, and 4.41 after the simplification will be equal to 2.1. So we have got 1.5, and after that, we have got from this simplification plus or minus 2.1 divided by 0.9. This is what I was telling you, that if you take the minus sign, 1.5 minus 2.1 will be equal to negative minus 0.6 or whatsoever, then divide by 0.9. So the answer will be minus 2 by 3. Time alone cannot be negative. Every other value can be negative at some point of time or the other, but never the time. Because I have already told you, if time is negative, then what will happen is whatever time is already gone, that will come again. As it continues like this, I had also mentioned at that time that one day Indira Gandhi herself will be alive. This is all next to impossible. Why next to impossible? It is definitely impossible. So that is why the negative value cannot be taken into account. And by taking the positive value alone, so it is equal to 1.5 plus 2.1, which is 3.6. And 3.6 divided by 0.9 will be equal to 4 seconds. So 4 seconds is the time taken when the two particles are going to meet. When time is 4 seconds, distance will be 1.2 into 4. So that is going to be. So S will be equal to, therefore, 1.2 into 4. Now the distance is in meters, so the answer will be equal to 4.8 meters. The problem is over now. Okay. So keep waiting till the board is cleared for the